son of Ra will never give up, and neither should we. Don't you know what happened to him? Family?
Honestly and truly, just off the bat, the first thing that you notice completely is the fact that the extra year, you can see the amount of love that they put into it. So the world is much richer, the textures are way deeper than anything. And on top of that, so what's very interesting about this one especially is that just how culturally accurate it is. We're talking about the Ptolemaic era of the Egyptian Empire. Combat's been overhauled from the ground up. It plays a lot more like something like Dark Souls, or more accurately, probably like For Honor.
It's looking good. I like some of the new stuff that they've added, and definitely looking forward to seeing, you know, what the full game looks like, learning more about this new Egypt story.
It was a lot more difficult. So I got attacked by multiple enemies at one time. I could also hit multiple enemies at one time, which was a lot different than we've ever seen. You know, with Ezio, you just wait till someone swings, step back, stab the guy. And it wasn't like that at all. It was very real. There was a lot of dodging. Oh yeah, the map is huge. It's way bigger than anything you've ever seen before. He's had 16 kilometers by 16 kilometers, which is just absolutely massive. It's going to take a long time, even by horseback. So it was just awesome. It was really awesome.
The controls are a little bit different, especially when you're using, like, what is it, the Eagle Vision. Instead of it panning out and just like showing you the area around you, you could actually control the eagle and go to a location and mark the location, see the level, the enemies, so you know what you're going to get into as you visit that area.
I like that they went back to the roots, like how it used to be. There's not like all this extra stuff. Like, I didn't really like the pirate ships and everything from like the last ones. I liked it just like simple, like back like the old ones. It was probably the first one that I ended up buying since number 3.
It was incredible. It felt really good. It flowed really well. It wasn't slow at all. A couple little things with the combat could be adjusted, but it's an alpha, so couldn't really expect too much, but it was amazing, man. It was really good, and I've been playing Assassin's Creed since the start, and they're taking a good step for sure. They're in the right place.
I absolutely love the game. I've been a big fan of Assassin's Creed ever since it came out, and knowing that a new one come out, you know, I'm very excited to play it.
I enjoyed the fact that now it's not just one button press to do the combos. You have the heavy attack and the light attack. I did feel that the assassinations were a little bit, they weren't as good as they were before, but this is the early build.
Honestly and truly, because it's the same developers that did Black Flag, so it looks like they've learned a lot from their time with Black Flag and kind of expanded upon that. So honestly, this one might shoot right to the top. But I'm also a little biased because I do love Egyptian history. But for sure, I'm going to tell you right now, Bayek is going to give Ezio a run for his money.